Okay, number 64. I'm going to use this one for an explanation to give you the wonderful value of this type of lesson. It's important that you read a lot and you listen. That's the way to learn English. So this is number 64, Does a Tiger Change Its Stripes? Okay, so you have these many tools to use, right? You have a dictionary, you have an image finder, you have this voice that will actually read this to you in good English, good sound, and you have a translator over here, okay? You got all kinds of tools and you need to use them when I give you this lesson, because it's a complete lesson itself. You will learn sentence structure, you will learn pronunciation, you will learn vocabulary, and you will learn phrasal verbs, you will learn idioms. You got the message, right? Okay, let me go through this briefly to give you some idea about that. Now, tiger, okay, I look it up in the dictionary. Okay, let's look it up in the dictionary first. Okay, so the dictionary comes up and we type in the word tiger. Okay, and the beautiful thing about, let's go to the word first. Okay, this will pronounce it for you. There is a phonetic spelling of it, but best way to do it is to listen to it.
Tiger. Tiger.
Okay, tiger. You heard that, I hope. It sounded good enough. And you have the definition of it. A large, carnivorous, tawny colored and black. Well, that's okay. Okay, maybe you can picture that. Okay, maybe this gives you all the written information about it. Okay, if you go down, it's quite extensive. It gives you all kinds of use of the words tiger. Okay, it gives you all kinds of forms of tiger. It gives you the origin of the word tiger, word origin and history, how it came into English, where it first came from, the word itself, okay? It looks like it came from the Greek, okay? So it's interesting if you want to explore this word, okay? But you don't have to do that. Another important part about this is, since you are, most of my students are Spanish speaking, you can click here on the Spanish and it will take you to the Spanish word, okay? And here you can see the Spanish word tigre, okay? This is tiger, this is a Spanish word, okay? Very good. Okay, let's go back. Then I'll click off that here. We go back to Melissa. Now, we get the explanation of tiger, okay? But, you know, pictures is worth a thousand words. So let's go to here and type in the word tiger, okay? Because this finds an image for you. So we go, and here we go. And we come up with tiger. There he is. Good old Mr. Tiger. You can see his stripes. And you can see that I don't think the tiger can change its stripes. And that's what the expression means. Can a tiger change its stripes? It refers to people. Can people change their characteristics? Can they change their habits? Can they change who they are? Well, generally the answer is no. But anyhow, this is a picture of one. Now you don't have to really imagine what it's all about, right? Because you got a picture of it. Okay, here we are. So, as I said, you can listen to this. You click on here.
Melissa had heard about Bill. He was a womanizer. He dated one woman after another, telling one lie after another. He was a pilot, a tiger trainer, a banker, a publisher, a tycoon, an investor, an adventurer, and on and on. He laughed about how easy it was to deceive women, dress sharp, and drive a luxury car, and they would follow you anywhere. Bill could get almost any woman he wanted, and then he discarded them like so many empty water bottles.
Okay, reads the whole thing, and you hear it pronounced, American accent. It's correct, his pronunciation is correct, and you can just practice after him, okay, if that is your choice, okay. Now, the other final part of this, or not the final part, but the next part I want to show you is the translator. So we can go in and we can take a portion or take it all, it's up to us, and we can put it into the translator. Click on translate and we'll take you to the Google Translate, okay? So we click it and we paste it in there, and I've got it already set up, and as you can see, we have the English here and the Spanish over here. Now, it's not perfect, but it's pretty good, and so you should try to use this. It's a fast way to learn what is being said, because these are Spanish words equivalent in English, and it is a good way to learn. Okay, we're back here again. We have the translator, we have the dictionary, we have the image maker, we have the sound, you know, and then when you've done all that, you know, it's a good way. It's the best way to learn is do it yourself, okay? And then you memorize it, but you remember it. If I do it for you and I give you all the definitions, it's not as good. You don't remember as good, okay? Then you have these down here. You go to the vocabulary, and here are all the words. New words you can add to your vocabulary. Maybe you know them all, that's okay. But if you don't know them, then just click here onto the word, and it will take you to the dictionary and the word in the dictionary, okay? So we have the word here, and we can click here and hear it pronounced.
Carpet. Carpet.
Okay. And we can read the definition here, of course, as I've already seen you. And then we can go to the Spanish, and sometimes it's a lot faster. And then you have the number, the name of carpet in Spanish, alfombra. Okay, there you go. Okay, let's go back and let's go to the next one. Yes, no questions. Here you got the instructions. So you're going to answer this question. Had Melissa heard about Bill? Okay, so you put the answer in there. It's more or less a yes, no answer. Yes, he heard about Bill, you know. And what you can do is get a hint. Now it comes up a Y, but it doesn't seem to appear here. But it will appear. It should appear. Okay, once you've got the answer and you think it's correct, then you hit check, and it will tell you whether it's correct or not, or what mistakes you had made. And if you really, you know, you can, if you really can't do it, you show the answer, okay? So we have the answer. Had Melissa heard about Bill? And the answer is yes, she had. Okay, good practice, good practice. And so we need to do that. Then we go to one of my favorites, close. And what you do here is you fill in the blanks here with the words that was in the story, and you fill it in here, and You know, you go through the whole thing, and you come down here, you can get hints, and then when you finish, you can check it to make sure that it's okay. Okay? And then we go to dictation. This is great. Man, this is so wonderful. It's a complete lesson. You hear it. You do everything that you could possibly do to understand this. Then we go to dictation. And this is where somebody reads something to you or says something to you, and you are to put the answer here. Or not the answer, I'm sorry, what you heard here. And then you check it. Okay, so I'll give you a little sample of that.
Had she heard that Bill was a womanizer?
Okay, here you fill in what you heard. Is it correct? And then you get the same method, hint, check, so forth. Then show the answer. And the answer is, had she heard that Bill was a womanizer? Very good. And then finally, if you're really, really, really ambitious, you can go to the crossword puzzle. And you can, that's a good way to learn your vocabulary. All this you need to do. Because if you do all this, you will understand what was this story was all about, and you will learn vocabulary and grammar and so forth. You can see we have the numbers across, the numbers down, and it's great fun. It's great fun. You should try to do this. It's not absolutely necessary, but I think if you do the whole thing, that you will greatly benefit. Okay? Well, folks, that's it. I'm going to let that stand as instructions for how to use this page. So all the other ones I will send you, do it this way. Be self-motivated. Do it yourself. Because when you do it yourself, you really learn and you really remember it. Okay, folks, I will see you another time. I'm going to put this on YouTube, so you can always refer to this. Okay, bye-bye.